And when I reflect on my career, what this occasion, the thing that strikes out, stands out more to me, is how much love and support I've gotten over the years in every sector of my life, beginning with being the fourth child of 10 kids from my mom and dad. And that love support, which told me that I had to do the best I could do, whatever I tried to do. But to always remember that whatever I did was also done as a soldier against the racial oppression that we faced. They didn't even have a lot of lectures about what they said and what they did. I came to know that I would always be a part of the resistance, that we had that responsibility. And that followed me throughout my entire career, even from elementary school to high school and to university, Southern University, because everywhere I went, I had the support of the folk. I remember someone mentioned about the citizens in Southern, when I think 16 of us were expelled. But what I remember most about that now is when the president called us in to let us know that he was expelling us, he was the one that was crying. Because he had that sense of solidarity, no matter how it appeared, that he, and we came to realize that he too was in our camp. And in every other station in my life, my students, my faculty colleagues, and some of the students who became faculty colleagues, everywhere that love and support said to me that as black people we knew and we know that we're all in this together. And I'm just grateful for all the love and support that I've been given at every place, and including NCOPS. NCOPS has been, for me, sort of a security blanket. NCOPS colleagues have always been there, and we've been a team, and although our contributions may not have been as great as we would like them to have been, we've always been a part of the resistance. And when I look over the 50 years of NCOPS, the seeds that we planted 50 years ago have blossomed into such a very important and committed organization. When I look at the young people now, I am really, really proud to say that I and my other older colleagues have been a part of the process to allow these seeds to blossom into the great organization and wonderful people we are now. I am just grateful, and I thank you all very much. And I look forward to whatever future that is there. Long live the struggle, long live the NCOPS. Mm-hmm.